Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can print this pattern on console using C programming. Before starting, you can note my information. You can follow or subscribe my YouTube channel through the link that is youtube.com/SanjayGupta_TechSchool. You can download my Android app that is TechImage, which is available on Google Play. Now coming on to the topic, first we have to analyze this pattern. Here you can see some space is available and then letters are printed. So I am modifying this pattern by typing this. Here you can see I am replacing all the spaces with hyphen so that you can identify how many spaces are required. So if we count spaces and letters, you will see in first row 4 spaces and 1 letter is required. In second row 3 spaces and 2 letters are required. In third row 2 spaces and 3 letters are required. In fourth row 1 space and 4 letters are required. In fifth row 0 space and 5 letters are required. So here we have to implement two loops, one for printing space and another for printing letters. To print first row, space loop will repeat 4 times and letter loop will repeat 1 time. To print second row, letter loop will repeat 3 times and space loop will repeat 3 times and letters loop will repeat 2 times and so on. So this way you can implement two separate loops for printing spaces and letters. Now to control these two loops, that which row we want to print, then third loop is also required, which will be controlling these two loops for printing spaces and letters. So first I am implementing that loop for I equals to 1, I less than equals to n, and I plus plus. So this is the first loop which will tell which row we want to print. So I will be providing the row numbering. So initially it is 1, so value of I is 1, so it is providing row number 1. When I plus plus will be performed, so value of I will become 2, so it will indicate row number 2. Now inside this loop I am implementing another loop which will print spaces. So this loop is for printing spaces and it is repeating n minus 1 time. So here if you identify number of rows, so let's say number of rows are 5. So in first row 5 minus 1 space are required, then 5 minus 2, 5 minus 3, 5 minus 4 and 5 minus 5. So 5 is fixed as n and then it is decremented by 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are row numbers which will be available by I. So here we can write this n minus I. So this space loop must be controlled by n minus I condition. You can see here I have used n minus I. So suppose initially n is 5. Through this printf and scanf I am reading number of rows. So suppose n is 5. So first time I will be 1. So 5 minus 1. That is 4. So this loop will repeat 4 times. When I plus plus will be performed, value of I will become 2. So next time 5 minus 2. So 3 will be available. So it will print 3 spaces, then again 2, then 1 and then 0. After printing spaces, I am implementing one more loop, that is k starting from 1. This k loop will repeat I times and here k plus plus is available. So inside this loop I am printing %c and ch and then I am incrementing value of ch by 1, and before starting space loop I am initializing value of ch as a, and variable ch is declared above and its data type is char. So you can see this third loop is printing letters and it is controlled with I. Here you can see in first row one letter, in second row two, then three, then four, and then five letters are required. So if you are working on first row, then one letter is required. If you are working on second row, then two letters are required. And row numbering are provided by I. So this letters loop will be controlled by I variable. And you can see it here. Its condition is k less than equals to I. So k loop is controlled by I. After completion of k loop, for new line, I am using slash n. So this way I have implemented complete code. Here first loop is controlling row, second loop is printing space, and third loop is printing letters. In third loop, ch is continuously incremented. After increment, its value will change, and every time we have to start printing letters from a. So that's why before these loops I have initialized value of ch with a. So every time when k loop will be starting, ch will be providing initial value as a. Now I am executing this code. You can see the output. The required output is available here, as it is available in this notepad file. So you can compare both the patterns. Both are printing same values. So this way, with the help of this C code, I have printed the required pattern on console. I hope you have understood how I have implemented this code to print the required pattern. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can open my YouTube channel through the link, that is youtube.com/SanjayGupta_TechSchool. Thank you for watching this video.